So hello everyone, in this video I am covering the mathematical functions. Mathematical functions are essential part of any project, and you can work on them easily in Grasshopper. Mathematical functions are found in maths, script and evaluate. So if you can see it, there might be more variables. You can add them by the plus sign and remove them by the negative sign. So it have the inputs like expression. You enter your expression here, and these are the the variables. So I will explain to you this by just telling you examples. The first example will be I will be making a parabola. So we know that formula for the parabola is y equals to x square. So you can put the expression value by right click on f x star x. Now it's done. Commit changes. So it have turned into the red because there's no domain on which the values will be generated. So actually, before that, let me show you one more thing. There's one more way by which you can put the value of expression. To do that, go first, let's remove this one, this value, and commit changes. You can do this by even add by connecting the panel. So it's time for the defining the input. So to define the input, we will need a sequence. So let's make a sequence. I am defining the range domain of -5 to 5. Here you can see. Then I will connect it with the sequence, and I will connect the step size. Let's say I need 50 points, 51 points, and then connect it with the. So our sequence is ready. Let's connect it with the x. Now we can't see anything. So for the visualization purposes, let's go to vector and the points. And this particular thing, it will give us the value of y. Connect the y. Here you can see we are getting the y values. And to see the full effects of parabola, connect this range with x. Now you can see the parabola here. Let's make a curve, spline, nerves. So we'll be making a nerves curve. Nerves. So we will connect these points to the vertices, and you can see the parabola over here. Let's minimize it and go to the top view. Here you can see the curve, but you can see there's a distance between the origin and the curve because the parabolas would give 0 at the 0, 0. So to control that, you can increase the step size. So there will be more step size there, and more closer the mathematical curve we get. Actually, the nerve curves are controlled by the the control points, and nerve counts don't actually follow through the control points. So the parabola is a explicit function, because explicit functions are those where with the help of one variable you can get other variables value. So let's go for the implicit function. Here in the other example we'll be making a circle. So let me explain you one by one the whole setup. So let's just focus on this one. We can define the circle in parametric form using radius into cos theta and radius into the sine theta. So we will require few values. So what we are doing here, at the first you can see there are two values. Let's rename it. This one is defining the x, enter. This one is defining the y. So you can see I have renamed the variables here, one to the theta, one to the radius. So let's work with them. So our first function will be radius cos theta. Okay, we are just connecting it. Now it needs the values, other values like theta and radius. Let's the radius is 5, and I've defined the the theta in a range you can see using the range function here, which is between the theta is between 0 to 2 pi, and I am getting, you know, 144 points between them. Let's connect the theta here. So we have actually the x component ready. So let's connect it with x. Now we need the y points. So here our equation is y, and we will get the theta from the same source, and our radius is here. So let's plot it. First let me disable it. The points, yeah, this is disabled. Now let's preview the circle. Now I can see there's just x coordinate, and let me connect the y, and you can see we have the, you know, the whole circle. Let's draw a nerves through it. Go to spline and nerves. Here we have the nerve curve. Let me zoom it so you can see a fine line passing through these. So we have, you know, the circle ready. Now you can, you know, you can even go into the 3D. To enter the 3D, let's first change to the perspective. Okay, we can go from here, restore, then perspective maximize. So you can see we have a circle here. Pan, let me pan it. Yes. So let's enter 3D to enter the 3D, let's define a value. Let's put this y value for the chat. And you can see we have entered in 3D. So, you know, this is how you can, you know, work with functions, even if you have, you know, the explicit function or implicit function, you can control it very easily. If you want more variable, you can just, you know, click on plus and keep getting variable, otherwise remove them. So that's it for this.